So this power supply is quite ancient. So all the electrolytic capacitors have been changed, as have all of the regulators on the back. Connection wires have also been changed because they've gone very brittle over time. Rectifier diodes have been changed, and then once it was powered up, the plus or minus 15 volts were trimmed out so that they measured accurately, so that the op amps can have a virtually zero DC offset at the output. The tantalum capacitors have been replaced for electrolytics because of their age. They are very old. These are the two pots that were actually, the shafts were broken off, the release and the OSB control. So the pots we got long stems and they weren't an exact match, so we've had to file off the faces so that the knobs will fit properly. So. This battery is the original battery. It's measuring, as near as damn it, 0 volts. So we're going to replace that one for this one, which has got slightly different tags on it, but it'll do the job for the time being until we can source a more direct replacement. I just glue in this battery down to the board just to make sure it doesn't move. As part of the restoration of this Prophet 5, one of the faults is that one key doesn't sound. Here you go. And you get that one not working. Doesn't sort of work. It's a bit strange, yeah? But if you get to that one, hold it, every single key will sound. So the fault is probably with one of the voices. Okay, so I need to work out which voice it is. I think it's the fifth voice, because that doesn't sound always the fifth. So this is the voice board, and it runs in this direction. This is voice 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and it steps a little bit. This is where all the filtering goes on to create those tones when you sound it. Okay. So what I'm going to do is trace back from the output point and find out where the signal disappears. Okay, we know it's not at the output, so we'll just go through it and find out what's going on. You'll see that this IC is actually in a socket. It's because we thought it'd be interesting for you to see the process, so we've put it back in to show you the actual fault. Okay, so if we go to this key, this is part of the output from one of the VCFs, yeah, and this is the faulty one, okay? And you can see from the scope, that's the actual tone. It's a sawtooth waveform. If I go to one of the other keys that do sound, so that's the waveform as well. Okay. So we can see that the waveform for the faulty one into the output stage, or driving the op amp in the output stage, are the same. Okay. If you trace it through, it goes to this IC. You've got an input which is there, and the output pin is pin 7, and as you can see, it's a stupid waveform. the IC that we've got isn't actually the, well, it's not the original, because the original was a UAF 772. The schematic says TLO 82. We haven't got one of those. We've got a TLO 72, which is close enough equivalent to, for this purpose, to get it up and running. Okay, so that's the IC we've got. Let me find the key. That's the key. So that's the input going to the op amp and the output from the VCF, which is a voltage control filter. And now the input to that IC, and now the output to the IC. You can see the waveforms back. So we know that that key is now working, and that VCO is generating a tone. So that's a fix. Basically, those are noises there because we've got nothing selected with regards to the oscillators. As soon as I go into there, we get a tone. But none of the presets work at the moment. They're all really bad. Okay, because we haven't downloaded it because it was empty. This switch needs to be set to enable for recording. We're going to download the factory patches. This is version 3.2, so it only takes 40 presets. So it's, I've got the three files, but only needs the one. That's taken from a laptop through a cable into the cassette in on the back. So I'm just going to set it to record, which is hold the record button and load. And now I play that audio. It's finished downloaded. The tune LED is lit, and now it's come back and the display's on. So with any luck, that's put the banks back into the presets. So we'll hit that and two, and now we'll see. Yep, so that's loaded all the presets. So we can go, that's number two. And so on. So that's all of the factory presets reloaded. First 40. That's all this one will take because it's 3.2. So that's it working. Thank you.
Thank you.